Hello friends, this video is continuation of generic part 3. You need to watch part 1, 2 and 3 to have better understanding of generics. Link is provided in the description box. Here we shall cover queue interface that includes introduction to queue interface and priority queue along with examples. Queue interface is available in java.util package and extends the collection interface. The queue collection is used to hold elements that are about to be processed. For example, printing documents job to the printer device. It is an order list of objects with its use limited to insert elements at the end of the list and deleting elements from the start of the list. That is, it follows the FIFO, first in, first out principle. However, queues typically but not necessarily order elements in a FIFO, that is first in, first out manner. The Java queue supports all methods of collection interface including insertion, deletion, etc. Priority queue and linked list are the most frequently used implementations. Let's understand priority queue. A priority queue in Java is a special type of queue. It has ordered elements according to its values. This can be a natural order or based on comparator. Whatever ordering is used, the head of the queue is the element that would be removed by a call to remove or pull method. In FIFO, all new elements are inserted at the tail of the queue. Let's understand natural ordering of priority queue with an example. Here we have created object of priority queue named queue that holds only string type data. After new priority queue, the angular bracket may remain empty. This means it is same as written for reference variable. Here reference variable is queue. In next few lines, we add some names to this queue and as stated earlier, queue adds them in sorted order. And for this, queue takes help of comparator interface. Every time when we add, it gets added at the tail and comparator checks it with the previous added elements. If the new value is greater to the previous value, then values are interchanged. So cities that are stored here looks like this. Here both element and peak method retrieves the data, but they don't remove it from the head of the queue. Element method is derived from abstract queue and peak method is the method of priority queue. The difference with these methods is when the queue is empty, element throws no such element exception, whereas the peak returns a null value. Next line uses iterator method to get iterator object. However, iterator written by priority queue doesn't offer any ordering traversal guarantee. This means the loop next used with iterator object will not show data in sorted manner. That is the way it is stored in priority queue. This is because priority queue stores data in binary heap. But unlike binary search tree, here value of parent node is always greater than its child node, or value of parent node is always smaller than its child node. This depends on priority. That is binary tree. However, iterator reads data with level ordering for the tree. Here both remove and pull method retrieves as well as removes the head of this queue. However, remove method, which is derived from abstract queue, throws no such element exception, and poll method returns null if the queue is empty. Here we have removed two elements from the queue. Then while loop is used with poll method to read, remove and display each element from the queue. Let's move to the next slide, comparable interface with priority queue. Question that arises here is, what if we want to sort employee list? Here, employee has several attributes like name, designation, salary, etc. And we want to sort employees as per the choice, meaning either name-wise, salary-wise, or designation-wise. In such case, we must perform sorting based on comparator. Let's understand this with an example. In this program, we have created three classes. First one is employee class to store data. Second is salary comparator that inherits comparator interface. And to use this for employee, within angular bracket we specify employee. Third one is a class to test these classes using priority queue. The class employee stores name and salary. Here compare method keeps checking set of two objects from the queue data. Initially first and second object gets compared and then second with the third object and so on. When the method returns non-null value, then comparator swaps this object. When the method returns value 1, means first object must move to the second object and second to the first one's location. Return 0 means no swapping needed. Here salary comparator's compare method compares employees by their salary. The method here returns 1 for less than operator, so we get salary wise employees in descending order. This means when we don't define class with comparator, then it returns null for the method compare. Moving to the main method, first line creates object of priority queue for employees and it implements customized order as salary comparator. By default, compare method returns null for priority queue object. To use any other comparison, we may write different class having traits of comparator interface. Next few lines creates objects of employee class and initialize values to their field variable. Then we add these objects to the queue. As we know that when we add the object to the queue, it gets added at the tail and comparator checks it with the previous added elements and so executes compare method. Next we used while loop until queue is empty. Here we used poll method to read and then remove element from the queue. Next line we display field variables of the object read. So here we end the session. Any further queries? Do post it as comments. It will be answered. Do like, share, subscribe for more videos. Thank you.